Previously on Detour.
Muli naglagablab ang apoy sa bahagi ng tinikaran trail ng Mount Apo kagabi.
Ayon sa Mines and Geosciences Bureau Region 11, maaaring magdulot ng haze ang patuloy na pagkalat ng sunog sa bundok.
Gawas na, gawas na!
Six days went by, and there was no update in the media about the Mount Apo fire or what had been done.
People got frustrated because we had so many volunteers when the fire first started, but the Bureau of Fire wouldn't let anybody camp up here. So basically, you have to walk 5 hours up to the fire site, work for 3 hours, and then hike back 3 hours. So by the time you even got to the fire site, you were so haggard and tired that it was frustrating. So this is going on 2 weeks now that this fire's been going, and they've ran out of volunteers just because the whole bureaucracy of it was pretty stupid to begin with. And they say, we do it for the safety of the people. Okay, yes. But they only have one helicopter and they only fly it every other day, it seems like. We have no chainsaws up here today. We had them yesterday, the day before. Then you get groups that bring chainsaws up and go, oh, we don't have any gas. So it's just like, it's frustrating.
So I wrote an article, Mount Apo Fire, What Went Wrong? It was a first-hand account of what went wrong. I may have white skin and be called an Americano, but I have called Davao City home for the last 21 years. If you take your car to the mechanic, you do not ask him what is working. You ask him what is wrong so you can get it fixed. That is what the article was for. Was it true? 100%. It stated the facts, but it didn't come without repercussions. Monday, April 11, 911 and civil defense pulled out. April 12, Bureau of Fire Protection sent the remaining men to me with the order to finish the job. Region 12 DNR, team of nearly 70 men and women, left April 13 as they had been on the fire non-stop for 3 weeks. They knew we could handle the remaining work. The supplies they came with was all we would have. April 14, Thursday at 11:30 a.m., we put out the last fire. A fire that was actually in an area that had no fire line as it was at the bottom of a ravine and had the potential to reignite the whole mountain again. We had finished the job we set out to do. 29 Bureau of Fire Protection men, 3 from DART, including a girl, myself, and a handful of Lumites. They were the last team standing. They finished the race, as we had put it.
We'll be done. Oh, that's a good feeling. Tonight, I'll probably come back up here with a couple of the guys. We're trying to get a thermal camera to see if we can see if there's any hot spots here, but otherwise, it looks like we're all done. If you look, turn around here without falling down. There are firefighters up there behind me. They're spraying a little hot spot over there. But once this is done, we're all good to go home. We'll camp here one more night. Yeah, get a little scratch, a couple of scratches. Part of life up here. But it feels good to actually be part of the team that made sure that the fire was out. The last group left on Monday, today's Wednesday. Monday group said, fire out, let's go. Fire wasn't out. Now the fire's out. In a couple more hours, we'll be done. Lord willing, and we go home.
I believe the men and women who fought the Mount Apo fire are heroes. They did it for country and the nature we love. The Mount Apo fire brought out the best in a lot of us. It brought together Detour, a show aimed at showing what we have and what we're losing, and how just with simple things we can change the way we are taking care of the ecosystem around us. Good or bad, the choice is down to us. What we do with our lives, the consequences that it will cause for us and the next generation. That is the purpose of Detour.